McFarland's through, he might go for it, still going, trying to barge his way through, goes to the shot, what a goal!
Arriving, Rian O'Neill from an almost impossible angle, and that's the rousing score I'm now looking for.
This Conor Turbitt kicks this one in, oh, that is absolutely superb.
Hello everybody and welcome back to the Sideline Eye podcast. We have a second homecoming podcast today. We were in Moheray on Tuesday night as Aidan Faulkner, Ben Creel and Kieran Higgins took the Sam Maguire Cup back home to their own club. We spoke to Aidan Faulkner and there was a few words on the stage as well. Joe Fox, the chairman of the Moheray club, spoke, as did Aidan and Kieran McGinney as well. So we have a bit of a montage of the night coming up. Then we'll hear those speeches and we'll hear from Aidan at the end of the show as well. So thanks everybody for tuning in over this last while. It's been an exciting 2 weeks leading into 3 weeks now, and that's only going to continue with the club championship coming up as well. So we'll see a bit of the montage of the night and then into the speeches and finally Aidan at the end. So thanks everybody for tuning in.
Blood will dry underneath my nails, and the wind will rise up to fill my sails. So you can doubt and you can hate, but I know no matter what it takes, I'm coming home. I'm coming home, tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits and they're forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home, tell the world I'm coming. Still far away from where I belong, but it's always darkest before the dawn. So you can doubt and you can hate, but I know no matter what it takes, I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits and they're forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits and they're forgiven my mistakes. I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home.
Okay, folks. Chairman of Moheray, Sean McDermott. I would like to welcome my nephew, Aidan Faulkner, with the Sam Maguire to the shores of Loughnane. I would like to congratulate the team, all 42 of the panel, and members of the management team and backroom staff for this fantastic achievement. It's been brilliant. On this historic occasion, I'm going to give a special mention and invite to our three winning All-Ireland players, Kieran Higgins, Ben Quayle. And this man here, Aidan Parker. Kieran Higgins was a member of our club. We won our first senior championship in 2016, scoring the winning goal, and we'll never forget him. And we'll never forget him for that, sorry. And we'll beat Cully Hannah. Ben Quayle, what a fantastic game Ben had on All Ireland final day. And on many previous occasions, both Armagh and Mahari. Ben also played on our first senior championship winning team in 2016. Ben's parents, Brandon and Denise, and extended family are very proud of him here today. London may have its famous clock, but we've got our Big Ben. And finally, the first ever All-Ireland winning captain from Mahari, Sean McDermott, our very own Aidan Fogger. Aidan is a very dedicated Mahari man and was also a member of the team that won our first championship in 2016 and of course 2020. Aidan's parents, Dipton and Joe, and the entire Fox and Fogger family, too many to mention, are very, very proud of him here today. A special mention to Emer, and our boys Leo and Ross, who have also sacrificed so much for this win. Finally, as chairman of the club, let's give one big Mahari cheer to Aidan Fogger and the All-Ireland Champions of 2024. Yeah. And I hand you over to Aidan to say a few words.
Me, Ben and Higgins went rock, paper, scissors before on the bus there to see who would speak. Funnily, I lost. I was actually more nervous coming down here this evening than I was from the last 4 or 5 days, to be honest with you. I got a wee bit overwhelmed there walking over the bridge. But obviously this is where it all started for us as Mahari men, kicking ball out here. Never in our wildest dreams did we think we'd be here with Sam Maguire. The most coveted thing in all of GAA, I suppose. So I'll never put into words how proud I am to be here to represent these boys here. And I will say, me being here at my own club, yes, it's super special, but this club here represents all these boys' clubs. This could have been anybody's clubs. Every player in this team is a leader. And nothing would have happened without every single player. Just the formalities in terms of thanking all the people who have worked tirelessly for all their clubs, but in the last 6 hours I think there was a serious scramble to try and spread the word and keep up tradition to have the homecoming for the first club to come to the captain's club. So as I said, I'll never be able to put into words. I was trying to think on the way down the road on the bus what words I could say, but it'll never measure to what this means and what I felt walking over that bridge. And I just hope that this inspires so many people, not just in Mahari but across the county. So I'm going to stop talking now because I'll end up crying. But thank you very much. It's unbelievable. This image that I see right now, I'll see it to the very day to day. I started here in Mahari. I will end it here in Mahari. And this day will live long, long in my memory. So thank you very much. I would love a man I looked up to who was my hero There's many heroes in Moheri that I looked up to, and many heroes in Moheri who we drove past at the top of the road who aren't here with us today, that mean so much to me, and they were my heroes growing up. But this boy was one of my heroes growing up on the TV and playing for Armagh with number 6 on his back, and I'd love him to say a few words. That's Kieran McGeaney.
Thank you. I thought I was going to get off tonight, but I didn't say anything. Listen, it's a fantastic welcome here to Moheri. Many's a day I've got a lot of lessons out in this pitch, both on the ball and off it. All the ties out there. But it's always been a... Like, one thing I could always say about Moheri is when you came here, you knew what a game of football was all about. And all of those values and attributes, I suppose, that helped make Aidan the man that he was, and the other two, with Ben and Kieran. The three Moheri fellas have been unbelievable in this squad, like in terms of their commitment and dedication. There's never a question why, what, how, where. They just turn up and they work their asses off for us. Aidan has been one of those players from when I came on to the Armagh scene like 10 years ago. I met up with Aidan, Rory and Stephen Sheridan, and the three boys especially have been instrumental in pulling this team up by the bootstraps from Division 3 up into Division 1 again, and now All-Ireland champions, and that cannot be overestimated. When a lot of men chose to walk away, those three fellas were the younger, and along with the Brendan Donachies and Brookies and Charlie Vernons, they were the ones that pushed Armagh back to a new level. And it's easy to be a good player when things are going well and people are clapping you on the back, but it's hard to be a good player and even harder to be a great leader when nobody wants you to do that. And in fairness, that says everything I can about those boys, and especially Aidan. He's worn a captain's armband for the last 10 years along with those fellas. This is probably the first year he's officially done it. And no better man to lift the Sam Maguire than Aidan Farker. And then you have Ben Creeley, like, what a performance in an All-Ireland final. Two points from play, outstanding in the middle, and then makes the tackle that wins us the game. It's unbelievable stuff. And everybody else, he's not a forgotten man. Kieran Higgins has been unbelievable in our panel. He's the one man everybody, pardon my language here, children, but everybody shits themselves when they have to mark him in training. He's an unbelievable team player, and he's always been front and centre for this squad when we need him. He's very shy individual. He doesn't put himself forward, but when it comes to doing anything at training or helping the team to be better, he was always front and centre for that. So listen, thanks again, and to the three Moheri boys, we're very proud of them, and you should be very proud of yourselves. Thank you very much.
Sing our anthem. Are you ready?
This seems to be my party piece. Ready? Right, give them a big cheer.
Ashes of fire.
Aidan, taking the Sam Maguire Cup over that bridge and into your home club, how does that feel?
Yeah, it was quite overwhelming, to be honest with you, at the start. Especially just, you know, Kieran and Ben beside me was just amazing. Like, two great friends and great people, and to be in that sort of same mould as I, like, I hold those boys in such high regard, and everybody who was behind me, all those teammates of mine, to be walking with Sam Maguire in the place where you grew up when you kicked ball with no one was here, and yeah, super, super special. Hard to put into words.
Coming across the bridge, I was up there seeing you, it got the better of you nearly. You did get quite emotional, and that's probably a natural reaction when you achieve something like this.
Yeah, just like, it's hard to hear like people saying so much nice things about you. It's hard to believe that they're talking about you, you know. You aspire to be all those things that people are saying, but when they say that you are those things and you've been those things, it's quite hard to hear. It's quite overwhelming. So and just people in the crowd who you kick ball here behind you with for years when you were just a lad running about, and friends who were there underage, and Oculus and all them things. It's a special time for me, yes, but for everybody here. Like,
Aidan, everybody keeps talking about the 10 years that obviously that Kieran was there, but you've been there even longer than Kieran has. You come into the panel, I think it was 2012 you made your championship debut. It's been a long journey for you, a tough journey at times too. To get up them steps, how did you feel once you got your hands on the cup?
Yeah, try to put a bit of meaning on it over the last 24, 48 hours. Like, just great validation, to be honest with you, for all that I believe in as a person, and hard work and belief and just being disciplined and turning up every day and chasing something that's, in a lot of people's eyes, is unattainable. And so a lot of affirmation and a lot of validation for what I truly believe in, and it's great to get that success at the end by lifting Sam Maguire for this county.
And Kieran McGeaney was, of course, the last and until Sunday the only person to have done that, to do it under his stewardship, all he has been through the last 10 years and particularly the last couple of years, to do it for him. And I think that was the message that an All-Armagh player said, he's wanted to do it for Kieran McGeaney. To finally achieve that, it must be a great feeling.
Yeah, listen, I said it in my speech, like, this would never ever have happened if Kieran didn't return home 10 years ago. I thought, I knew what it meant to put Armagh first and be an Armagh man and what was best for the county, but he just showed us another level and another standard that I really just grabbed onto as best I can, and don't think no one will ever emulate what Kieran's done for this county. No one will ever know the time, the thought, the emotion, the effort, and just Armagh's in his bones, and I think you need that in order to achieve something unbelievable. Like, I think people forget what we're the fifth or sixth smallest county in Ireland. Like, that's unbelievable, and to take us where he took us from and show us and what it takes, and have that belief that was unwavering in all this group, just it's hard to put into words, and no one will ever understand, but I think the joy here is tangible, that we felt the whole way through the county in all these homecomings.
That's the last one, Aidan. The last 48 hours have been crazy. What's the next 48 hours, 72 hours? What's the next couple of days going to be like?
No, we'll take a bit of downtime. I'm looking forward to just watching the game and taking it in, and all the build-up and getting everybody's story, I suppose, and spending time at home. Like, it's like, we haven't been really at home too much, and I've family at home myself, and I probably haven't got to spend as much time and soaking it up as much with them. But it'll just be a time of contentment that we've achieved what we set out to do, and I'll enjoy time at home with family now that the season's over, and hopefully the boys keep celebrating as well.
Good stuff, Aidan. Thank you.
Thanks, man.
Come on.
Curlin's through, he might go for it, still going, trying to barge his way through, goes to the shot, what a goal!
Arriving, Ryan O'Neill from an almost impossible angle,
And that's the rousing scoreline that we're looking for.
Connor Turbin kicks this one in on an absolutely superb.